Good afternoon, Colt here from techinform.us with an overview of the iPod Nano first generation and a little bit of a discussion about it. Let's go ahead now and cue an overview video of this box and what is inside.
Alright, so on the front of the box we have an iPod Nano, Apple logo on the side, and another version of the iPod Nano on that side. Nothing on that side, and back to the front. Flip this around, 1 GB, 240 songs, PC and Mac compatible. Let's slide this open. Designed by Apple in California, as all Apple products are. Let's open the box here. And there's the iPod itself. Pull it out of the box, puts the box to the side, and there's the iPod. Very thin, even by today's standards. There's the back, very scratched up, as that mirrored finish always is. Again, other side, very thin. And the front, also scratched up, but has that old school iPod look. On the top, we have a hold switch. And on the bottom, we have the audio jack and the iPod connector. Front of the iPod has the old school Apple click wheel, and let's just set this down.
All right, so you can see the iPod Nano is still, by today's standards, good looking. And that's awesome, right? So why is it in this video? Why are we talking about it? Why all of a sudden are we discussing this? Well, if you didn't hear, a few days ago, Apple announced that they were recalling the batteries in the iPod Nano first generations, the device you just saw. And the iPod Nano first generation, I've had sitting on my nightstand over there for months and years. I haven't used it. I haven't used it for music in 3 years since I got an iPhone. I haven't used it for music. I also own an iPod Classic, so that kind of killed my Nano use. So why would I use the Nano? I wouldn't. I don't. But I'm still going to send it in for the battery replacement. Why? Simply because I got a new iPod. You saw in that overview video, it is very scratched up. It works, but the bottom button of the click wheel is having some issues with sticking, and why not? Why not get a brand new refurbished? I think it's going to be refurbished. It might be brand new. I don't know. Why not get a brand new iPod? So I will be sending in my iPod to Apple. They are sending me a box in the coming days slash weeks. I'm going to throw my iPod in there, and I'll get a new or refurbished one within a week or two. So that is awesome. I get a new iPod that is 5 years old. How cool is that? So if you have an iPod Nano first generation, just wanted to let you know, go to Mac Rumors or Tech Inform is currently, I saw a post in there I need to edit. There are links to an Apple support page or an Apple form. I don't know exactly what it's called. Basically, you just find your serial number, which is located on the bottom of your iPod Nano box. And basically, all you got to do is enter that serial number. If your iPod was made between two certain dates, you have the battery. I have the battery, and basically what you can do is enter the serial number, sign in with your Apple ID, and they'll basically send the box off to you. So that's what I did this morning, and everything I hear, I should have a box on the way. So with that said, send your iPod in. If you own one of these, why not? You know, get a new iPod. If it's scratched up, if it's broken, send it in. It's covered by a freaking 5-year warranty now, apparently. So yeah. Just wanted to let you guys know about that. I know a lot of you guys wouldn't have known about that if I didn't say this, so I figured I'd help you guys out. So with that said, follow me on Twitter, twitter.com/ColtonFry. Check out the website, techinform.us. Check out my vlog channel, youtube.com/ColtVlogging. And with that said, I will see you guys in the next video.